circulatory system. What we call it? What is called as circulatory system, which should be consist of blood, blood vessels, and also heart. Okay, we see in the blood, which consist of blood, blood vessels, and heart. All these we can be called as the circulatory system. So many blood should be a different function, blood vessels, circulatory function. All these can be seen in the circulatory system. So this is the supply of the nutrients. What is the main function of the blood? Means supply of oxygen and nutrients to heart and deoxygenated blood. And also another function to the deoxygenated blood should be from the cells. So this is the main function of the heart. You can be seen here. So this is also helping the clotting of blood. It should be clotting of blood also. So in blood, you can call as the transmission system, and also can call as the circulatory system, consist of blood, red vessels, and heart. So the main function of should be the supply of the oxygen, nutrients, and also deoxygenated should be the deoxygenated blood. And also main function should be the clotting of blood. So what is the heart? So when it is situated. So first we can discuss about the heart, where it is situated. So heart is then one of the muscular organ. It can be called as one of the muscle organ or muscular organ. Okay, so heart is the one of the muscle organ which is situated in the left part of the chest. So we have the left part of the chest, no? That left part of the chest. Of chest and also abdomen part. The part of the chest, the thoracic part of the thoracic part of the region. Thoracic region. So the main function should be oxygenation blood and also deoxygenated blood should be the close to the base. So this is the main function to the one. And also it should be helpful for the main purpose of the pumping of the blood to all of the pumping of blood all over the body. So and also it should be consist of the four chambers. So this is the intermediate part, is the four chambers, right auricle and also left auricle, left right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle and also left ventricle, right ventricle and left ventricle. The upper part of the chambers what we call is the atrium or atrium. So lower chambers can be called as the ventricles. So totally we have the four chambers in the heart. So yes, the upper chamber of the heart same as the atria, lower chamber can be called as the ventricle. So first, how should be the function of the this blood? So you know that veins should be collected, veins collected. So whatever these veins are here, so these veins are connected with the oxygenated blood. Okay, so if veins should be connected with the deoxygenated blood, so deoxygenated blood from the heart, so that is the we can be called as the right ventricle. So this is the right ventricle, whatever there, so they be whatever veins are there. Heart, we can be seen in the lungs to pulmonary veins. Again, belongs to pulmonary disease. This pulmonary disease should be responsible for the oxidative state flow to them. Oxidative blood flow on them. So again, belongs to the what? Pulmonary disease. Pulmonary disease to left atrium. So pulmonary disease to what? Left atrium. So we can think about this is the left atrium. After left atrium, it should be go to the what? Left atrium to left ventricle. Left atrium to left ventricle. So again, they can be moved to the arteries. There are arteries somewhere. So these arteries should be the carry the deoxygenated or oxygenated carry the oxygenated to the all part of the body. This is the brief explanation of the how should the circulation should be occurring in the blood. So whatever the veins, so veins should be connected the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle. After right ventricle, you can go to the pulmonary arteries. This pulmonary arteries move to the all over the body to the lungs. Again, oxygenated to be entered to the pulmonary. So for this pulmonary vein should go to the left ventricle, left ventricle to left ventricle, where it should be movement to the oxidative to the all over the body. So this is the brief explanation of the circulatory system of the human being. So next one is blood vessels. So what is the main function of the blood vessels? So arteries are the carry the blood from the away from the blood from the body. So they can be called as the carriers of blood away from the body. So they need to be carry the blood away from the heart. So away from the heart. They have the because they will be thick walls. They consist of the what? Thick walls. They carry the deoxygenated blood. So they carry what? Carry deoxygenated blood. So they consist of what? Blood capillaries and veins. So they have pulmonary arteries deoxygenated blood. So they should be carry deoxygenated blood. They have to thin wall. So we can generally define as that blood pressure is BP. So blood pressure means when blood is excited or not, when blood is excited or not, wall of the blood. So wall of the blood. Excited or not, blood vessels is called BP. So in BP it can be seen in the two types. One is diastolic, another one is the systolic. Repeat number this. It can be seen in the systolic pressure. Another one is the diastolic pressure. So what is the meaning of systolic pressure? Blood vessels is called what? Bleeding. So it is the, we have the four types of the blood vessels, maybe RBC, WBC, platelets, and also plasma can be part. Here platelets, whatever they are, that platelets should be helping of the clotting of blood. So when the blood should be bleeding, we can be able to cut the shaft of the this blood. So blood, it is also a gel-like substance. Okay, it is a gel-like substance which for the platelets. It should be consist of the platelets, you can be seen. Next one is double circulation. So we have to the double circulation in human beings. Why do we need double circulation? Means one systolic and another one is diastolic. Double circulation. The human body blood circulates to the total of heart is twice. It is identified as the double circulation. In human heart, blood is flowed to two times. Blood flows two times. That is, we can define as the double circulation. So, all Another one is systolic circulation. Systolic can be defined as the double circulation of the human veins. So only lower animals you can be seen that is the diffusion process should be occurring in the blood should be flow some other organ. Especially in this you can see the vascular system divided the flow open type of the circulatory system you can be seen. So this is the transportation system in the animals. So next we can be discussing about the transportation system in the plant. How should be the transportation should be occur in the plant? We can be discussed here. Transportation system. So we have the blood, but plants do not have any blood. They have the tissues. We can define as the tissues. The tissues means it is a group of cells which perform a different function. Here we can define as the tissues. So here, depend upon the tissues, we have called vascular bundles. So vascular bundles means it is the xylem. It is the constitute of number of xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem, that is we can define as the tissues, and other than we can define as the vascular bundles. So it is the Purkinje process. It is one of the Purkinje process we can be seen in the plants, because plants do not move from one place to another place. They have the restricted, they have to, plants should be growing in the all over the body. So when water should be absorbed, so there is then two systems you can be seen. One is water connected tissue, another one is water connected tissue, another one is food connected tissue. So water connected tissue you can be called as the xylem. So this term you can be called as the phloem. Food connected tissue you can be called as the phloem. So whatever water should be absorbed in the plants with the roots, that root should be moved to all over the plant body, upperward direction, that is the responsible for the xylem. Like that, phloem means whatever food product are there, that should be transported to the all over the plants or leaves, that is the thing because of the phloem issue. So generally, xylem should be consist of the xylem nucleus. It should be made up of xylem nucleus, vessels, xylem vessels, parenchyma, xylem parenchyma and xylem vessels. And xylem fibers. So this is the construct of the xylem. Next one is phloem, we can be seen in the sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem fibers, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. So this is the main transport system in the plants. So phloem is one of the responsible for the transportation of the food substances, especially whatever you can be seen in the amino acids. So the amino acid means maybe carbohydrates, lipids, amino acids, carbohydrates, lipids, whatever solid substances are there, all these they can be transferred to the one part of the plant to another part of the plant. They have consist of the sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, also phloem fibers. Whatever the photosynthesis product are there, that should be stored in the plants, they can be transferred to the all part of the body. So materials in the sieve tubes should be located in the these food substances. The bulk of the flow of the materials should be responsible for the these phloem tissues. So xylem means only water connected tissue, whatever minerals are there, water minerals and some salt are there, they can be observed. So this is always unidirectional. So this cycle should be always what? Unidirectional. Unidirectional means only single direction it can be passed on to the backward. So this is the xylem and phloem. So xylem means water that can be distributed can be called as the xylem. Food that can be distributed can be called as the phloem. So here movement should be always unidirectional, but phloem is the not unidirectional. It transports the movement into the whatever in the leaves. So whatever water is observed to the plants, they will be passed on to the all over the body, is it? So there is the various processes can be seen. So one is it can be inhibition. So one is inhibition, another one is osmosis. So next one is it can be called as root pressure and also transpiration pressure. Root pressure and also transpiration. These four doses, they can be helpful for the transportation system in the water in plants. So inhibition means what? So inhibition means water is absorbed by the plants. They can be solid substances. Some solid form of the substances that is called as the inhibition. So maybe water absorbed in the solid. So water is absorbed. So because for example when seeds should be soaked on the water, they can be transferred to other regions. And the seed is soaked on water. This is the main example of the this inhibition process. Like that, you know that osmosis is the movement of the water molecule or water solid, which can be moved from the higher concentration to the lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. This can be called as the osmosis. So root pressure means it creates a column in the water. So it creates column on the water. So that is the unit of the root pressure. So generally you know that the desert and plants, whatever they have the waxy metallic color. So because of the excess of water should be not moved to that one. So transpiration means is the loss of water from the area part of the plants. So that is the mechanical part is the transpiration. So all